Where did it go? Puzzle lovers, my name is Michael and welcome to the 5th episode of the Loop & Lock series. So today we are going to solve another nice wooden puzzle. This one is called the ball. Why? Because of its shape. And from the outside it looks like the barrel that I did in episode 1 of this series. I will put the link up there, which also includes the history of the Loop & Lock puzzle. If you are curious, go watch it and let me know in the comments which one you prefer. So now, let's go and try to solve it. So here is our wooden puzzle that we need to solve today. The aim, again, disassemble it and reassemble it back to its shape, which is the difficult part of this puzzle. Now, again, it looks very nice and very well made. I'm really so amazed about how these wooden puzzles are made because they are really very neat, very well made. I mean, it's a lot of small wooden pieces assembled all together to make this nice shape. Really, it's such a nice work. Now we can go and try to solve it. So we will try to find out which piece is kind of a masterpiece. Like it's the one that usually comes off first and that you will put back at the end, at the last. So you will always have this kind of loose piece that is just getting out of a puzzle easily. And it looks like this. So it's made of two wooden pieces. Very nice. So it's really, again, this barrel puzzle experience. Like, I had the same kind of pieces that I removed first. Really the same. Two wooden pieces on the top that I could remove. So let's see what are the next steps. So I can already move this one here. So I guess that I can remove it. Yeah. Okay, so we can remove this one. That will be on the side. So I will rearrange them in kind of order to remember, like, how it goes. So it's easier to put it back together. It's also a nice technique, I guess, as a puzzle solver to remember where each piece go. And now we can continue to solve this puzzle. So we are looking for the next one to go. So we have these two pieces that seem, yeah, they can be moved together and then it unlocks another part of the puzzle that we can take off. And we have these nice two wooden pieces that really work so well together. Now I mess a bit with them, but I don't think it will do anything bad for the next step. I don't know which one do I need to remove now. I feel I want to remove this one in the middle, but this one is locked. Oh no, okay. So you can unlock it by pushing it out from the middle of the puzzle. So it will play as a, yeah, as a lock. So there will be some pieces going here that you can lock. And I guess that also free the other piece. Yeah. Okay, so we need to remember this one. This one need to go at the side. And then we have the middle one here. And then we can just remove this. No, we cannot. So, or we can remove this one at the bottom. So this one was also locked by this one, I guess. Not really, actually. Or maybe like this instead. Yeah. Looks nice together. So we have this one that goes out and then, okay, so then we have all the puzzle that can take apart. So we have this cylinder part here, another part that came from the middle. So it's this part that play a key role actually, because you can use them to lock everything. And then the last piece. So the disassemble step is done. So we removed everything. Now we can really see the similarity between this one and the barrel puzzle. Really, like, we have again these two wooden pieces, but act like a middle lock, but you can put all the other wooden pieces inside, and that's very nice, that's very ingenious. And then everything again is so well made. Every wooden piece has its own purpose, its own shape. It's really like so amazing to see a puzzle like this. It's really a great work, and it's just so beautiful, to be honest. Such a nice puzzle. So now our next step is to put back everything together to make our ball shape. That will be the challenge of this puzzle. So we will start with these two big wooden pieces that goes on the side and that make the actual shape of the puzzle. Now we need to be careful of where everything will go. So we can already see that this here will be for these two locks that we put like this, and they already find quite easily their space here, because it's really like the middle component that kind of have a big role that does everything for you to remove each piece on this puzzle. So we can start like this with these two, and now by order, I know there was this one at the bottom like this, but was kind of also locking everything together like this. So then you can continue to play with your two middle pieces, but everything kind of stay together. I think the next step was, I think it was one of the lower part. So also we need to make sure that these walls align. So if you remember, we have this big piece in the middle that will lock everything, and then that maintain the puzzle all together. So we have this. Now the next step that we have is this one will have to come here, I think. Again, you have to be careful of this wall. So it will be like this, I suppose. So you have like a flat piece here. And then I will put this one to use as a lock. So I need to push these two middle ones to give me the space to put this one. So I need to put it like this to catch all the walls. So then I can lock everything together. So it should be okay, like this, yeah. Okay, so I have my piece together here. Now I need one of the side. They look exactly the same, so just one of them. I will put it here next to it, and then I can close my middle lock like this. And now I can put the second side piece on the other side like this, and then I will push it to the extreme side of the puzzle, so then I can get enough room to put my last piece. So I push it back, and then the puzzle, it's already done, because you have these two last pieces that go together. So this one goes like this, so it gives this flat surface, so everything can be fitted back to the original position, and you just have to fit it back here where it came from. And then, like this, with this nice clicking sound, the puzzle is all back together and looks like a ball again. Woohoo! So yeah, another Luban lock puzzle solved. Finish. Another one. Another wooden puzzle solved. Yes. So nice. They are really something. This wooden puzzle looks so neat and so well made. I mean, like, each piece have a unique design and a specific position in the puzzle. So everything is so well designed into this puzzle. If you would like to try to solve puzzles, I really recommend wooden puzzles. They are really nice to start with, and also they are very enjoyable for anyone who like to solve puzzles. Really, give it a try. They are really nice puzzles. I hope you did enjoy this video. If you enjoy this kind of puzzle, I will put the playlist of all the other wooden puzzles I solved so far. They are really nice. Each of them have a different shape, different difficulty and also a different solution. That makes this wooden puzzle very unique and so nice to solve. So go and check out the other videos, I'm sure you will enjoy them. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, it will really mean so much to me. I will see you next time for a new video. Tschüss!